Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Wajua ndugu Lucas, ni neno limekuja tu kwa akili zangu, kwa fahamu zangu, kwamba a day is coming people will be tutakuwa tunaweka namba za simu alafu you book for testimonies. Bwana asifiwe. You'll be booking for these testimonies. For now they are free. For now na watu wanakumbelezwa kwa shumide. But the day is coming, you'll be booking. Bwana asifiwe. You'll be booking not because hakuna time, but because hakuna chance. Chance iko occupied. Watu ni wengi wanataka kutestify. So utajikuta kwamba ukisema two testimonies ukisita wawili wameruka mbele mara moja. So you will be booking. Unajua watu wakiwa wengi hivyo sasa inabidi mweke utaratibu fulani. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Because many people want to give testimonies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Watu wameshangaa, sio? Meshangaa. Things happen. God is not asleep. He's very much awake. And he's doing his things. And when his things are complete, you receive it. When as if you were.
Amen.
You know, these words we say to you, they'll come to pass. Soon or later, they'll come to pass. And when they come to pass, you will remember that we say it. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Wajua, Mungu pia anafurahia unapomsifu, unapomtukuza, unapompa sifa, anafurahia. Na pale penye kiti cha enzi, unapomsifu kwa moyo, anasonga. Anaposikia mtoto wangu ananisifu, anasonga. Alafu that's when you find he releases a blessing. Baraka inaachiliwa kutoka kwa kiti cha enzi na kujia. Hapo unabarikiwa. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Tunatafuta baraka, si ni kweli? Kuna mtu hapa hatafuti baraka? Kila mmoja anatafuta baraka. How do people seeking for a blessing look like? Watu ambao wanatafuta baraka wanafanana na nani? Wanakaa namna gani? How do they look like? How do they behave? That's a question each one of us should ask. Do they look like me? Watu ambao anataka kubarikiwa, do they look like me? Are they like me? Mtu akitaka kupata pesa nyingi kwa mfano, nasikia kuna kazi zingine, kuna OT. Sijui OT, you know, Old Testament. Odhiambo Thomas. Una OT. Overtime. Wanaita OT. In other professions, unfortunately, profession yangu haina OT. Kana ukatafuta upate OT uwezi pata in my profession. But other professions kuna OT. Kwa hivyo naweza kufanya OT. Unaongezewa masaa. Tajiri anakuongeza saa. Alafu unaweza kuta badala kufanya 8 hours in a day umefanya 20 hours in a day. Fanya mchana na usiku. Umefikisha 20 hours. Nasikia hiyo OT inalipwa double. Bwana asifiwe. That is working extra, beyond the normal time. You're working extra, so as to earn some extra coin to meet your expenses over time. Bwana asifiwe. How much money do you want?
Much.
Much. Much. How much is much? You see? I was sitting somewhere and And I asked myself, if someone asked me how much money I needed now, how much would I declare? Then an answer came on my lips immediately, because I need $1 billion in Kenya shillings. At least $1 billion, it has solved some few predicaments here and there. $1 billion, one has a few. Wengine wakasema kwamba nitaomba tu Mungu anipatie enough. That's good. Wanaomba kama yule jamaa katika Biblia, sio? Alisema Mungu usinipatie nyingi sana nisije nikashiba nikakusahau. Wala usininyime nisije nikawa maskini nikaiba. Bali nipatie enough. Bwana asifiwe. That's good. If you are not able to handle money, don't ask for much. Ask for enough. Bwana asifiwe. That means you are very weak. You cannot handle money. Money can handle you. So we are not asking for enough. We are asking for what? We are asking for plenty. We are asking for plenty, not enough. Plenty. You know, when you have enough, nikija kwako sipati chai, because you have just enough. So you don't have, hata nikija kwako nikwambie nina shida ya fare, kwenda town, kwenda Nairobi. Na niambia, kile nilicho nacho ni kidogo tu, siwezi, you have enough. But when you have plenty, ya huoni shida, unatoa tu wallet, unasema shika, enda town. Because you have more than enough, you have plenty. So, people who need plenty do extraordinary things. So if we want plenty, we must do extraordinary things that no other man has ever done. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Nani anataka plenty? Okay. Thank you very much. That's very good. So be ready. Be ready to do some extra work, okay? Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Ukiona vyaelea, ujue vimeundwa. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Wahenga walisema hivyo, si ndio? Ukiona vyaelea, ujue vimeundwa. Mtaka cha mpunguni, shati inani. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana pewe sifa.
Amen.
So I beg that we look for more than enough, not just enough. Look for more than enough. But if you know you have a weakness in handling money, then ask for just enough. God will give you just enough. Asikunyime, usije ukawa maskini ukaiba. Asikupe nyingi, usije ukala ukashiba ukamsahau. Bwana asifiwe. But sisi tunaomba, you know, someone with a vision does not ask for enough. Mtu aliye na maono haombi, God give me enough. And naomba, God give me plenty. I need plenty because you have a big vision. Big vision ahead. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Now I want us to share a word today from the scripture. We want to talk about the man Jesus. The man Jesus. I'm going to read the book, the scripture from the book of Hebrews, Hebrania, Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 up to 4. I'll read there. Then I'll talk briefly. You cannot talk about Jesus and finish. You can't talk about Jesus in a day or two, because he is just awesome. You can't talk about him and finish. He is awesome. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 to 4. Nasema hivi. God who at various times and in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the world, who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become so much better than the angels, as he has by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Bwana abariki neno lake. Now, I want us to get a few insights from this scripture. From this scripture. Verse 1, nasema, God who at various times and in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets. So God spoke to our fathers in the old. When the scripture talks about our fathers, we are talking about the Hebrew generation, the Hebrew community. God spoke to them by the prophets in various ways at various times. And that's why we have the books of the prophets. We have prophets, so many prophets that came. Prophet Isaiah, Prophet Jeremiah, Prophet Ezekiel, and many other prophets that existed those days spoke to us, or spoke to our fathers, as they heard from God. That means God sent his prophets to speak to our fathers. Those were the Jews. And he spoke to them in different ways, in diverse ways. So you read the books of the prophets, you'll see the ways God spoke to the forefathers. He spoke to them at different times. Unasikia nabii anasema, and at this time of the year, the reign of so and so, God sent his word unto me. That is a time that God spoke. Now God spoke to some in parables and to others plainly, others in riddles. God spoke to the people of Israel in various ways through the prophets in the old times. But now, in verse 2, anasema, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the worlds. So we see that now, when we talk about in the last days, we are talking about the days that Jesus came to the earth. In these last days, God has spoken to us through his Son. And that Son is Jesus Christ. So God has spoken to us in this last day through his Son, Jesus Christ. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Now what the scripture talks about, God speaking to us through his Son, Jesus Christ, it does not mean that the books of the prophets, the books of the Old Testaments are now worthless. It does not mean that they are now useless. But they are still powerful, they are still useful to us. Why? Because all the prophets, as they prophesied the coming of Jesus Christ. They prophesied the coming of the kingdom of Jesus Christ. And all the prophets directed all the generations that existed those days to the coming of Jesus Christ, to the kingdom that Jesus was going to establish. And this is the kingdom that Jesus is establishing through us today. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So the prophets pointed to the coming of the kingdom of Jesus Christ. You read the book of Daniel, you'll find Daniel. This was a king in Babylon who saw a stone that was not shaped by human hands. And that stone hit a what? What did it hit? The stone hit the image. Remember the image here equal gold, whatever mixed it. That image. So the stone hit the image, and that stone grew into a mountain. And Daniel, in his interpretation, anasema, this stone is the kingdom of the Son of God that is going to grow to all generations of the world. It will grow and cover the whole world, the kingdom of the only Son, Jesus Christ. So the prophets prophesied the coming of the kingdom of Jesus Christ. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Na ukisoma maandiko inaonyesha kwamba Jesus himself was the fulfillment of the prophecies. Now let's see 2 Corinthians chapter 1. Let's see verse 20. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 20 nasema, for all the promises of God in him are yes, and in him, amen, to the glory of God through us. Well, as if you will. Now, Christ himself was the fulfillment of the promises God gave through the prophets of the Old Testament. And that's why Paul, quoting, said, Christ himself was the, for all the promises of God are in him, yes, and in him, amen, to the glory of God through us. What does he feel? That means the promises of God are fulfilled in Jesus Christ. So Jesus was the fulfillment of the promises of God. Bwana apewe sifa. He is the fulfillment of the promises of God. So when you have Jesus in your life, the promises of God are fulfilled in your life. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Are you there?
Yes.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Now, the same verse 2, anasema, the second part, anasema, whom he has appointed heir of all things. Heir. Kwa Kiswahili tunahitaji heir. Mrithi. So, Mungu akachagua Yesu kuwa mrithi wa vitu vyote. So Yesu ndiye mrithi wa vitu vyote. Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
So yeye akiwa mrithi wa vyote na nakaa ndani yetu. What does that mean? Tumerithi vyote, si ndio? Through Christ Jesus. The promises of God in him are true and amen. So if the promises of God were fulfilled by Jesus, Jesus appointed by the Father to be the heir, then Jesus lives in us. That means we inherit all the promises of God. And that's why as long we walk at Kingereza, unaiba standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of Christ by him. Through eternal ages, let his praises ring. Glory in the highest hours, shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God. We stand on the promises of God. Because Christ dwells in us. Christ, the fulfillment of God's promises, dwells in us. And therefore, him being appointed heir dwells in us. Therefore, we inherit everything that belongs to God, including all the secrets that God has. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Hizo siri wakati unapofika, that's why we grow from one level to another level. Tulisikia hiyo in the morning, sindio? We grow from one level to another level. So when you get to a certain level, certain secrets of God have revealed to you. You grow to another level, certain secrets are revealed to you. So you keep on knowing and discovering more secrets in God as you keep on growing. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
So do we want to know the secrets? Let us grow to higher levels. And those higher levels, you don't just walk there like you are walking in a park, like you are walking in a wool park. No. You work for it. Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
You do what? You work for it. You work for it. So him the heir lives in us. What does that mean? We are heirs together with him. Now, then, hiyo verse 2 anasema hii, through whom also he made the worlds. So that means the universe, the world, was made through Christ Jesus. Through Christ Jesus, the world was made. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Where does he view it?
Amen.
Mesoma hiyo. Verse 3 nasemaje? All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. That is John chapter 1. John chapter 1 verse 1 verse 3 nasema, all things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. So God created the world, the universe, through Jesus Christ. So he was there in the beginning. In the beginning, the world was without form and was void. And the Spirit of God hovered over the waters. Then he said, let there be, and there was. Let there be, and there was. God was creating the world through Jesus Christ. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Did you know that Jesus used to meet people in the Old Testament before he came in the human form? Before he came in human form, he used to meet people in the Old Testament, in the olden days, in the days of our forefathers. He used to meet people and could direct people and could show people things, could tell people things. But people never recognized him. They never knew him because he had not come on this earth. Instead, people used to refer to him as the angel of the Lord appeared to me. So they called him the angel of the Lord appeared to me. But in the real sense, he was Jesus himself appearing to people and giving directions and opening barren wombs and setting captives free and healing the sick. He appeared to people in the Old Testament. But people did not know him. When has he feel? Only the prophets whom God revealed to knew he was coming, and a day was set for him to come and to come to this earth in a human form. Then he came. When I pray with Zephyr. So Jesus came in a human form. Now remember, all power and authority is given unto him. That's why the scripture says he is the heir of all things. He inherits everything from God the Father.
And that's why when he came from the grave, after he rose from the grave, the first exclamation he said, all power and authority are given unto me. All power and authority. He had conquered the devil. He had taken the keys from the hands of the devil. The keys that locked people in hell, he had taken them from the hands of the devil. And he opened the prison cells. And people, souls that were bound, were set free to walk free. And were seen in Jerusalem streets, walking. Bwana asifiwe. Si unasoma maandiko, unaona hivi. After Jesus died on the cross, the tombs, makaburi yalifunguka. After the earthquake, tombs split open. And people who had died were seen walking in the streets of Jerusalem. We don't have time to read there, but it is in the Bible. Matthew 28. I just want to confirm to you that all power and authority was given to Jesus. He said it himself. Matthew 28, verse 18, inasema hivi. Verse 18. That's after Jesus rose from the grave. Akasema hivi. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Now, all authority was given to him in heaven and on earth. So not only in heaven, but also on earth. That's why when we call upon his name, when we call upon his name, he intervenes in situations on earth. When we invite him into our lives, into our earthly lives, he intervenes and changes situations because he has authority in heaven and on earth. So when he is called upon by you, the righteous ones, he intervenes in situations. That's why he heals the sick. He sets the captives free. He heals the brokenhearted. He heals the lame, the blind, the deaf. Those with different kinds of infirmities, he sets them free because he has power and authority in heaven. In heaven, he speaks to the Father on our behalf. He prays to our Father on our behalf because he has been given authority. And that's the Christ that we have today. The Christ who lives in us. One as if you imagine him living in us, living in our souls. Him, Christ, who has power in heaven and on earth, who has all the authority in heaven and on earth, living in your life, then we have power over everything. Because him who has power over everything lives in us. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Yes.
Then why are we terrorized? Bwana asifiwe. Do you know? When we have power, when you have the power, you have the authority, you need to exercise the authority. You need to exercise the power. One as if you. When you don't exercise the authority, then you'll be terrorized just like those people who do not have the power. You have it, but you don't exercise it. So we have the power because Jesus lives in us. One as if you.
Amen.
Do you believe that Jesus lives in you?
Yes.
You know, tuliza watu wengine, are you sure Jesus lives in you? Unaona doubt inaingia ndani yao. Muuliza tu, are you sure? Tuliza wengine, are you going to heaven or not? Sasa Mungu ndiye anajua. No, you need to know. You need to know. You need to know that I'm going to heaven. And if you are not going there, again, you need to know that you are not going there. You need to have it to be sure. One as if you were. You need to be sure of everything. Now, if you have the power, you need to know that you have the power. But again, I want to say, it is one thing to know that I have the power and authority, and it is another thing to exercise that power and authority. Now, when the demons attack, what do? Some of you get your phones and disturb Brother Tony. Start calling Brother Tony. Niombe tafadhali, nimepata attacks. That means you are a person who has authority, but you don't exercise it. You know, I've stood here on several occasions, nimewaambia, mimi tangu nimjue Yesu, I've never taken my phone to call my pastor, pray for me, I'm sick. Never. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm not being proud. I have never. And I've never complained that I was sick and my pastor never came to see me. Not that I don't fall sick. Nakuwa mgonjwa. Sometimes, mbaya sana. Let me shock you. Ngeniona tu nimecollapse hapa mimi. A few days ago. Ngeniona nimecollapse. Hivi kwa tunakuja na sikia akili ubongo unayumba kwa. Unayumba tu na kuta sasa naenda hivi. And I have to take authority. Now this satanic. And I took authority over that condition. In the mighty name of Jesus, I rebuked it. Say, get away from me. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana pewe sifa.
Amen.
If the one with power and authority dwells in you, then you have to take authority over every condition, over every situation that comes in your life. Take authority. You know, Captain ilikuwa pale patakatifu patakatifu before Jesus died on the cross. In the temple kulikuwa na mahali paliitwa patakatifu pa patakatifu. Only a priest, a consecrated priest, ndio aliruhusiwa kuingia pale. But when Jesus died on the cross, that curtain ilipasuka. Nasikia hiyo curtain ilikuwa nzito sana kiasi kwamba wanaume hata 10 hawangeweza kurarua. Bwana asifiwe. Statistics zinasema kwamba only 50 men washike, 25 washike upande huu, 25 washike upande mwingine ndio wararue. So imagine such a curtain. Hata na shiko ilitengenezwa na material ina gani? Ile pasia kifo tu cha Yesu msalabani, ile pasika katika kati at the Holy of Holies was exposed. What did this mean? It meant that now every believer has access to the holy place to call upon the name of Jesus Christ, and the Lord Jesus will hear you, and your situation will be turned around. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Now listen to me. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
I don't refuse. We need help. Sometimes kuna mambo nahitaji Brother Tom anisaidie kuomba, Brother Tony anisaidie kuomba. So I tell them, with this one, we need to pray together. Please pray with me over this issue. But there are certain things, very minor, petty. Zile naita ni petty. You don't have to disturb anybody because you have the one with power and authority dwelling in you. And this one, you call upon him, he is there with you. You call upon him, kapepo kametembea, sio? Unakamuru kwa jina la Yesu, hama! Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana pewe sifa.
Amen.
You see, if we do that, my good friends, Shetani atajua kwamba you exist. Atajua you exist. But you know there are some Christians whom the devil even doesn't know.
He doesn't know they exist. Why? Because they don't exercise the authority in them. They don't. So the devil doesn't know them. Bwana inatakana shetana tujue, sio? Ajue we exist, eh? Wakati anarusha mishale, ile mishale tunaishika hivi, tunairudisha kwake. Naona mshale aliyorusha umerudi kwake, unamdunga kwa macho, anashtuka. So kuna mtu mwingine pale. Anashtuka. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Hii na hiyo neno ni tamu, eh?
So all power was put in the Lord Jesus Christ. And that power is with him today. He's the heir of all that belongs to God. And through him the universe was made. Nothing was made that was made without him. So him, God made, through him God made the universe.
Colossians chapter 1. Wakolosai. Swahili kinaita Wakolosai. Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. Nasema hivi.
For by him all things were created that are in heaven and that are on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through him and for him.
All things were created through him and for him.
Whether visible or invisible, principalities and powers were created through him. And because of that, with his word, all these things are held together. Without his word, these things fall apart. But with his word, the things created are held together.
Vimeshikwa pamoja kwa neno lake. Now, ukienda the book of Genesis, unakuta kwamba God said, let there be, and there was. Let there be light, and there was light. Let light and darkness separate, and the two separated. Let there be a greater light in the sky, and he called the greater light the sun, and the lesser light the moon. The greater light to guide the day, and the lesser light to guide the night. And it was by his word.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Unajua? I was sharing a scripture in another meeting. And I read the book in Genesis. Ilikasema kwamba after God had created all things, he brought all the animals, birds of the air, the fish, and everything that creeps, crawls, brought them to Adam to give them the names. And Adam gave each of them a name. And those are the names the animals are called by up to today. The names that were given by Adam. Then it dawned to me that God gave immense power to Adam, that he could name things, and things could be named up to today. Their names have not been changed up to now. Then I said to the meeting, now it's your time to name what you have, what you want. Name what you want. Name it now.
and it will be yours. Name it. God gave power to Adam to name, and he named. So when you name, it happens. That's why mzazi akiita mtoto mjinga, that child becomes foolish. Because of the power of naming. When as if you will.
Amen.
That's why names have power. They have influence over people. Names. Adam named. Na hiyo majina ndio wanaitwa nayo leo. Those animals. You have power. Tell your neighbor you have power. Umesema kweli sikusikia. Mlisema? Oh, sikusikia hata kidogo. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So you, if you have power, the book of Proverbs inasema the power of life and death lies in your hands. In your tongue. The power of life and death. One day, husband and wife disagreed. Husband and wife disagreed. Then the wife, out of anger, said very dangerous words to the husband as he left for duty. And the wife said, literal translation, and you in my mother tongue, in a speak of Zulu, that you got to enter as a man, and you could see, Lucas, you could see, it's a very strong one. Inamaanisha huyu mtu asirudi nyumbani akufe. And for sure, the man never came back home alive. Was knocked down by a vehicle, he died. Because the wife named what she wanted. She wanted death. So the man died. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Another man was a servant of God. God was using him mightily. But the wife was an obstacle. Wife was really troubling the man. And the man got annoyed. And he's saying, you woman, Mungu akuondoe kwangu. And you know what happened the next? Wife died. The power in the mouth, right? Power in the mouth. Wife did what? Died. That's why I advise you, a child of God, when you get angry in somebody, you better shut your mouth. Shut it. If you cannot speak words of grace, please shut your mouth. Because what you may say may cause death. Well, as if you will.
Amen.
Like I said, he said, I'm a victim with this. One man annoyed me so much. He had fought my wife, not really physical fighting, but quarreled my wife for nothing. I kept quiet. As if that was not enough, he again started war with my children. Na nikashangaa huyu mwanaume na yana ameniona mimi mimi ni nusu ya mwanaume. Siwezi kupigana na yeye. Then I said, this man should die. The man died.
mysteriously. He was so healthy, very strong. He died mysteriously. As if enough was not enough, a daughter was crushed to death by a vehicle. It was so sad. Kambia kewangu, sometimes. The power of the mouth. The power in the mouth. That's why this nikisikia hii maneno itaniletea kutamka mabaya, I shut my mouth. I shut it tight. So utanikuta nimenyamaza na kaa kana kwamba sisikii. Kumbe ninasikia, but najua nikifungua mdomo huenda nikatamka neno mbaya nikamaliza mtu. So I shut my mouth. Bwana asifiwe. This confirms to me that the power of life and death lies in our tongues. So we can name things and they will happen because we have the power. And the one who has all power and authority. Si akasema, I give you power and authority. Alisema kitu kama hicho. Yes, mwenyewe. Kasema to us, I give you power and authority over every disease, over every demon. Na hata mkile cha kufisha hakita watu. Alisema hivyo, sio?
Yes.
The man Jesus, he gave us that power. So we are able now to exercise the power and authority over all principalities, over all powers of darkness, over everything that comes against us. We can exercise that authority. But again, exercise it wisely, because when we exercise it foolishly, we destroy. It is power that can kill, it's a power that can destroy, and it's a power that can save, it's a power that can heal, power that can set every captive free. So let us use that power to set captives free, to deliver people, to heal the sick, and to bring people to Christ. That is the main aim of that power and authority in the Son of God. The name Jesus means, what does it mean? It means Savior. The name Jesus means Savior. Remember, the name Jesus is a human name. It is a human name, it's not a heavenly name. Because there are other people who are called Jesus before them. Are you aware? Watu wanaoitwa Joshua, Joshua translated in Jesus. So, he came to seek and save that which was lost. And that is the main purpose for that power and authority. To seek and save that which is lost. Although at times we use it violently to destroy other people. Whereas if you... I had some people praying somewhere and nikasema, hey, how are you? Hey. Zima, the preacher was leading me. Nasema, do you have enemies? People said, yes. Do you have enemies? Yes. Now the preacher said, now we want all those enemies to die. Then Kamuna want to smame. Then people rose up. Then say na kawangoza komareno. No, now we want to cast those enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. All your enemies. Say all my enemies. All my enemies. Die. What want to die? Die. They say die 7 times. What were you some in numerics? 7. Mnaijua? 7 times. Say my die. So I asked myself,
Suppose God answered that prayer. Tutakuwa na vilio kwa hiyo nchi. Alikuwa tu anasikia huyu amekufa. Oh, huyu tena amekufa. Oh, huyu amekufa. Oh, huyu amekufa. Deaths will occur. The power we are given is not for destruction. It's not to destroy. I think my attitude has changed so much. As older as I grow, my attitude changes. These days I pray, God, so and so is my enemy. I ask for your grace for him and give him long time to live. Aishi miaka mingi. Aone vile unanibariki. Because they are not supposed to have power over us. No. We are supposed to rule over them. Because we have all authority and all power. And him who was given all power and all authority lives in us. Who is that? What is Ahab? Oh, I'm preaching alone. Who is that man? The man Jesus lives in us. Well, as if you will. The man Jesus lives in us. This preaching is very, very, I feel it very nice. I feel it very sweet. But now, my time is up. Before I finish, it is up. Let me summarize by saying this. Verse 3 nasema hivi. Who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high. Now, our Lord Jesus sits on the right hand of the Father. And according to Paul, he intercedes for us day and night. When Daddy plans to destroy you for the sins you have committed, our elder brother Jesus steps in and intercedes for you. As my Father, I died for him. Give him time. That's why you have all those opportunities you've been given, though you are supposed to be dead. But because of his intercession, day and night interceding for you, praying for you, sitting on the right hand of the Father, praying for me every day, every night, I still have a chance to say, God, forgive me for the sins I committed. I still have that chance. You still have that chance to say, God, forgive me. But let us not waste this chance. Because the time, the day, and the hour, no one knows when the Son of Man comes. Well, as if you will. He has power to keep you. He has power to sustain you. That's what Paul said. Let him who has power to keep you from sinning and sustain you be with you always. One as if you would. So him, Christ, is able to sustain us. He's able to keep us alive. He's able to keep us from sinning. He's able to keep us from our enemies. He is able to keep you from the wiles and darts of the devil. He is the sustainer. He will sustain us. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Therefore, we have to take pride in him. We have to take courage in him, because him alone has power to keep us. Him alone. And him alone. Now, but smile. Christ alone can keep us. He can keep us from sinning. He can keep us from the enemy.
Christ Jesus, who dwells in you. He has given you everything that you need. And He dwells in us. And when we exercise the power and authority He has given to us, then miracles happen. Things take place. The sick are healed. So as you sing this chorus, we are going to ask Him. You're going to exercise that authority that He has given you over every condition in your life, in your body, the sickness in your body. You're going to exercise that power and authority because He lives in you. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Oh, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. Satan's power. We shall overcome. Yes. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. Satan's power. Hallelujah.
Of sickness, be it the condition of lack and scarcity, be it the condition of poverty, take authority over those conditions in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you as we give you praise today. We worship your precious name because by this name we are saved, and by this name we have all authority, power, and oppression over everything that comes in our lives, Lord. Father, we give you all the praise and we glorify you today because, Lord Jesus Christ, you came to us, Lord, and gave us the power and authority over every sickness, over every disease, over every condition in our lives, Lord. And Father, nothing will rule over our bodies, nothing will rule in our lives that is not of Christ. And therefore, today, we thank today. Let your power be made manifest in our lives. Father, setting the captives free by killing the sick, by delivering all the bound in every area of life. Lord, we shall give you praise and glory. We honor you, King of Kings. We honor you, King of Kings. Thank you, mighty Father in heaven. We adore you and we bless you. We glorify your precious name. Lord Jesus, glory is Lord. We thank you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Thank you, mighty Father in heaven. We love you and we bless you. We love you and we bless you, Lord Jesus. Father, we come to you, Lord Jesus, now. We pray that in the name of Jesus, you touch these people and set them free from every bondage. Lord Jesus Christ, deliver all these people in the mighty name of Jesus. That all of them, Lord Jesus, will experience your power and authority. The Lord Jesus Christ, you shall speak in their lives now and forever, because you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you, mighty God of heaven. Bless each one of them, Lord Jesus Christ, every soul and every life. We ask for your blessings, Lord. Touch them, Lord Jesus Christ. We give you praise, Lord. Thank you for your presence in our midst, Lord. We ask for your power to move in our lives every day and every time. We shall glorify you. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
May the grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God,
the
Holy Spirit, be with us now and forever.
Amen. May God bless you all. God bless you. We meet at